Hey everyone, there was a time where you'd build a computer, or maybe you bought a pre-built, and it would come with loads of CDs, especially with the motherboard. There'd be absolutely tons of things to install. Nowadays, most of that is online, but what you might have noticed is you've built a computer, or you've just bought a brand new one, and you boot it up, and then your motherboard software pops up and says, hey, you need to be installed. You know, so it might be the Gigabyte Control Center, or ASUS one, or ASUS, or whatever else. But it comes up and says, you need to install me. And then when you do install it, it wants to install a bunch of crap on your computer. And yes, some of them are drivers and you actually do need them, but a lot of the other stuff is actually kind of crap that you don't need, to be perfectly honest. But that brings us to the point of this video. If you've just installed a motherboard and it's popping up saying you need to install loads of drivers, do you actually need to install it? Well, the short answer is, to be honest, on a modern system, like if you've got Windows 10 or Windows 11, Windows Update will usually take care of most of the important bits of software, including chipset drivers and things like that in many cases. And then basically you're just responsible for, like, if you've got a graphics card, you know, go into AMD or Nvidia or Intel's website and download in the latest drivers. You get the best gaming experience and things like that. That's really what you need to do. So often you can leave Windows deal with most of that and then just get the graphics card drivers and everything else. But if you do have expansion cards like networking cards, Wi-Fi cards, or, you know, PCI Express expansion cards and things like that, then downloading the drivers, you know, directly from their website or, you know, via automated software can be quite useful too. But certainly you don't need to download your motherboard's control software or anything like that. And actually, I've recently rebuilt this computer and then I changed the motherboard too, and at no point did I go out and download the motherboard drivers, because that's not really a thing. Yes, I've got chipset drivers, and like right now AMD is popping up saying I got more chipset drivers to update because Windows Update must not have handled that. But there's also something called AMD Privacy View. I'm not going to install that. I'll just do the chipset drivers equally. I've got an ASRock motherboard in this computer now, and I'm not going to go out to ASRock's website and download whatever stuff they've got on their website for that particular motherboard. I'm happy to just have, you know, the latest graphics card drivers, which I installed, and then have Windows Update deal with most of the rest, and then maybe keep an eye on chipset drivers and things like that, because they are important. You know, if AMD tell me I need chipset drivers, I'll probably update them. But that's it, really. If you've got any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. But other than that, I hope you enjoyed this short video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.